Well, agriculture has several ways of mitigating climate change. We usually say they can do four things that would add on top of each other to increase the storage of carbon in the soil. And that is not to plow the soils fully and to keep the soil covered with vegetation all year round. And the third thing is to add organic material back to the soil. And the fourth one, that is actually to have a good crop rotation. So you would increase with having maybe perennial grasses in the crop rotation or having legumes that also increases the soil carbon.
Many agricultural soils have lost organic material in the top layers. Regaining this carbon is not only important for the climate, but also crucial for yields and drought stability.
So here we are on the grass lawn, where it actually could be very similar to an agricultural field. And we have a soil profile where we have the dark zone here is where the most organic carbon is, which is brought there by the plants and the roots. And when we look at this profile, we can see how the roots are actually going through the soil, and it makes the soil to form soil aggregates, which keeps lots of the nutrient, lots of the water, and it's good for the soil health. When you compare with the below one, which is much lighter here, you can see that the soil kind of crumbles up in much smaller crumbles, and there is the much more mineral part with less nutrients. So if we want to mitigate climate change and keep soil in the pot, what we need to do is to increase carbon in the upper part and also extend this organic carbon further down into the soil as much as we can. The potential of storing carbon in the soil is great in agricultural soils where we have an intensive management because they've been losing carbon for several years. And in the grasslands that are also part of agriculture, there we have it. Already have a good potential and we have a good carbon storage, but we need to preserve our grasslands to really maintain this carbon storage.
The researchers are also studying alternative agricultural methods. In some of these, there may be a potential to increase carbon storage in the deeper mineral layers of the soil.
My name is Brangarí. I'm from Catalonia, and in my research, essentially what I'm doing, I'm combining models and experiments. Here we are comparing different agricultural systems. We are comparing the traditional wheat agricultural system to some wheat-like crop that is called kernza. The main difference between kernza and wheat is that wheat is an annual crop and kernza is perennial. Since it's growing during more years in the same site, it's also growing deeper roots. Deeper root systems, it means that it will bring carbon and nutrients deeper into the soil. And then we'll have also microbial communities decomposing carbon and recycling carbon in different depths. So we believe that these deeper roots will contribute to microbial activity in deeper profiles, and this can contribute to carbon sequestration in deeper soils. When you plow a soil, when you till it using a tractor, then you are also contributing to increase the carbon emissions. You mobilize all the soil system, microbial communities, they are more active and they emit larger amounts of carbon from soils to the atmosphere. The idea with kernza is that it's a perennial crop that is similar to wheat, so it will produce a similar type of cereal, but the difference is that it will stay in the system, in the soil, it will be planted, and then we will not need to plant it again until after 10 years or so. So then we don't need to plow the soil every year. And then this is contributing to stabilize more the soil, have more healthy soils, and then this will help sequestering carbon.
So in our research, we do work with both the soils and to see how the soil health is improving, but we also work with the farmers and to see how their economy is changing due to the soil health issues and the factors. And we are trying to model this so we can tell the farmers, if you do this for 20 years, you're going to have higher profits, you can put less nitrogen on your fields and your soils will be more resilient.